Hey, what's up, Ice Guys? Got a quick little video here on how I'm going to be doing the LYRID meteor shower. It's going to be on the 21st of April, and or the week of the 21st. You can probably see them before and after the meteor shower, and the peak, which is on the 21st. It's going to be happening, so here's north, and if you look towards the northeast, the LYRID constellation should be rising probably around 10 o'clock or so, and heading as throughout the night, it'll move up to the northeast and around. And you'll pretty much be able to see the whole night on the 21st. Hopefully, we'll have a pretty decent shower. And through the morning of the 22nd, and then again on the 22nd, the night of the 22nd through the morning of the 23rd. All right, just want to quickly go through my setup. I've got a D7000 Nikon on here. I've got the Tamron SP24, 1024, and f3.5 is the max f-stop on this. And I also have a Vello ShutterBoss on here, and I'll kind of quickly go through this with you. On the settings, I've got a 50-second exposure, and it's every 51 seconds it takes a picture, and I have it unlimited. So I'm just going to let it run throughout the night, all the way through the morning. I also have it hooked up to power, so I don't have to worry about switching the battery out like I did last time with the quadrants. And hopefully the power won't go out. I guess I could set up a battery on that as well, but I don't think it will. I've got pretty decent power up here. Okay, so quickly through the settings. On the image quality, let's see here, image quality. I took it off the RAW. I know a lot of people have said that they think that I should be doing RAW, but I don't know. I'm still not convinced. They're pretty big files, and I'm not too happy trying to convert everything. Okay, so I've got large JPEG file format with the fine, and I can't remember the actual image size. I'll post it down below on here. But real quick, so I've got the setting to bulb, and I've got my ISO set to 3200, and I've got the lens zoomed all the way out to the 10, and I've got my focus all the way over to infinity. And I'm going to be sitting out here in this yard with it and having it kind of up in the sky, so it's kind of getting a big wide range of the sky, hopefully the whole radiant. And now in my last video, I set up a towel on that if it was cold to kind of keep it, keep the moisture off the camera. And I also came up with another idea with a friend of mine. She does pretty cool things with snowflakes. And we were talking about how we keep the lens warm without it fogging over. We came up with this cool idea to take the bandage, when you go get your blood drawn, and they got that cool little kind of wax bandage thing that you wrap around. And we thought, wow, we take these Hotties and put them on the lens, upper and bottom, and let it keep the lens warm. So if you're trying to think of a way to stop the moisture from going on the lens and on the camera, that might be an option. I'm going to have to wait and see what the weather's like. All right, head over to our Facebook page, Ice Guys. We've got a lot of cool people there that are posting things and posting images of the things they're doing and observing. And if this video helped you out, like it and subscribe. Have a good day.